She walks in the bar one leg at a time. She knows she's cool, she knows she's mad. She's wild, drinks tequila straight. She ain't shy, she'll try anything.
Day 2 of 10 Pan South.
I'm here with Kelly, and Kelly is an old pro at these video blogs because I ran into him 2 years ago at the Jeffrey Steele Show. Hi, Kelly.
Hi.
And what brought you out tonight to 3rd and Lindsley?
Jimmy Webb.
Speak into the mic, please.
Jimmy Webb, this is wireless, right?
When I was a little girl, one of my favorite activities was to have mom put on a record or an 8-track on the stereo, and I'd stand on my parents' gold velour couch with a wooden spoon for a microphone, and I'd sing to an imaginary audience on my gold velour stage. One of my favorite albums to sing to was Glen Campbell live at the Royal Festival Music Hall. Like a rhinestone cowboy. When I first got iTunes, I poked around and decided to see if I could download this album, and sure enough, it was there. So I downloaded this whole 8-track that I used to listen to as a kid on iTunes as MP3s, and I was listening to it, and I'd listened to it for a week, and all of a sudden I thought, you know, that was recorded for a television show. I wonder if there's a YouTube video. Guess what? Performance from 1977, recorded for BBC television in London. This was Glen Campbell's 33rd album. In this performance, Glen was backed by the entire London Philharmonic Orchestra. It was cool as hell. Galveston, oh Galveston. On the staticky 8-track that I would listen to and sing with over and over again, Glen introduces his friend Jimmy Webb to conduct a few songs. I was little, I didn't know who Jimmy Webb was. When I grew up, I discovered he's a brilliant songwriter.
I was a highwayman. Oh, I did cry. With a sword and a pistol by my side.
When I googled Jimmy Webb songs, my computer damn near blew up. This, according to Wikipedia, is a partial listing of recordings and performances of songs written by Jimmy Webb.
I can hear you through the wire, and the Wichita lightning.
MacArthur Park has been covered more than 50 times.
MacArthur Park, melting love. All the sweet green ice going down. For someone left my cake out in the rain.
Friends, is music at its finest. No auto-tune, no computers, just an amazing voice and an orchestra. Doesn't get any better than that.
I'll tell you a little story. When I was 14 years old, I was driving a tractor in Oklahoma.
Jimmy told the story of how he was moved to become a songwriter.
So I was having my lunch, sitting in my car, listening to the radio, and I heard this song called Turn Around, Look at Me. I went down and bought Turn Around, Look at Me by Glen Campbell. That night, I got down on my knees beside the bed, and I said, Dear Lord, when I grow up, and I was 14 now, I'm not lying to you. And I said, Dear Lord, when I grow up, can I please write a song, something nearly as good as Turn Around, Look at Me. And could I get it recorded by Glen Campbell?
Jimmy, the world could not be happier that that one song moved you to create so many brilliant ones.
Who is high on that mountain?
To top off my night of amazing music, I wandered over to the Station Inn and heard Larry Gatlin, Bobby Tomberlin, Leslie Satcher, and Vince Gill.
So you were on the star. Oh, to live on a shelf. Love for the father and
fun things about Ten Pan South is it's very relaxed and laid back. You know, Vince wanders on stage, tries to figure out where he's going to put his water bottle. Fiddles around with his guitar chord. There's no curtain opening and grand entrance. Just music. Bobby Tomberlin has had cuts by Faith Hill, Kenny Rogers, Rodney Atkins, Joe Nichols, Terry Clark, just to name a few. He is most known for a gorgeous song recorded by Diamond Rio called One More Day.
Last night I had a crazy
One More Day was released in 2000 and went into heavy rotation for radio airplay following the 9/11 attacks a year later as a tribute for those who lost their lives.
Leave me wishing still for one more day with you.
Larry Gatlin is well known for singing with his brothers in the group the Gatlin Brothers. Quite pleased to see a successful female songwriter because the female gender is not one you see prominently on Music Row.
Singing above the crowd.
Leslie Satcher. She's written songs for women, Martina McBride, Pam Tillis, Gretchen Wilson, Patti Loveless, but she also wrote a single for the only one who holds the title of King in this town.
Sometimes I feel like Jesse James, I'm still trying to make a name.
They call him King George in these here parts, because everything George Strait touches turns to gold. Vince did impersonations of his father that were hilarious. His dad smoked cigarettes and had this gravel voice, so Vince would crack the audience up with these imitations of his dad.
And it was like, now listen, you're going to a place you've never been before. You better act right.
His dad called him one day with a song idea, and Vince didn't write it until years after his dad died. He originally thought it was a silly idea, but during a songwriting session when they couldn't come up with anything else, Vince and his friend Rodney Crowell started tossing his dad's song hook around, and they wound up writing it.
She ain't ever gonna quit. Oh, it's hard to kiss the lips at night, to chew your ass out all day long.
Day two over. See you guys at day three. Bye.
To dance half naked on the phone with the boots on screen.
Cause it took so long to make it, and I'll never have that recipe again.
I wanna be that girl.